Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Jesus, blessed Savior, he's worthy to be praised. I've discovered the more you praise the Lord in your life, the more you raise the Lord, not only in your life, but in your heart and mind. I'm back driving again. I can tennis match my neck now, no more whiplash, and I'm not sore at all. I'm grateful unto the Most High God, for blessing me to acknowledge him as God all by himself. He sits high and he looks low and he rules and he super rules. And I'm just grateful that the supreme being that he is, he's allowed me to come to the truth, the actuality, the reality, the realization that God lives. I don't care if you believe in him or not. I don't care if you say he exists at all. Regardless of what you say, he's God all by himself. You know, I'm not trampling on your unbelief. I'm not trampling on your disbelief. But I have a right just as much as you have not to believe. I have the same right to believe. But we must understand that right in the middle of the word believe, believer, belief, and believed, and believers, is a three-letter word called lie. So we must narrow down the lies and the old wives' tales and fables to get to the entire sum of the matter. I've met God in his own person. I've been blessed to meet the Most High God. I got hit by a car when I was 12 years old. And I couldn't walk. We lived in Norwood Projects. My mom and dad together had a combined income of $5 an hour with seven children living in the ghetto. No health insurance. They brought me home after they took me from under the bottom of the car. The lady drugged me from the corner of Yukon to the corner of Arctic Street. And when they had to jack up the car and they took the wheel off and the back of my legs were just mangled and burned, looked like Nestle Crunch and Jimmy Dean sausage patties when my legs started to scab over a few weeks later. I walking past this old lady's house, Mother Wilson, and she said, TD, what's wrong with you? And I told her that Miss Mary had hit me on my bike because she didn't see me. And she said, come in here. I want to pray for you. And I said, that's all right. She said, get in here. So I hobbled in on some crutches that my dad had brought home that he had found in a dumpster at work. And she put olive oil on my forehead and the sign of the cross. And if y'all don't know what the cross means, she said, a lot of y'all get caught up in religion. But if you just let me teach you something about the cross, just for these 30 seconds. The vertical portion at the top is God himself. At the bottom is us or me. I get the vertical right. I'll get the me and you right. So if you don't have the bottom to the top right, you can't have the side to side right. That's the symbol of the cross. God at the top, man at the bottom, and me and you across from one another. So if I get the relationship, the vertical right with God, the Most High God, then when I'm horizontal or meet someone who's going to be horizontal like me one day, and I try as best I can, you see, I can't treat everybody the same, but I can treat everybody right. I believe in the Most High God, High God. And so she started praying from the beating on this tambourine. And she said, every time I say, come out, Satan, I want you to say, thank you, Jesus. And her grandson's name was Tommy Wilson. We used to play together with Hot Wheels and 10 Speeds. And we used to go crawdad hunting and fishing and hiking and all over Madison County and all over the project. We ride our bikes everywhere we went. We rode our bicycles as I leave this alone. So she started beating on the tambourine, and she said, every time I say something, I want you to say, thank you, Jesus. And I was afraid. I wasn't but 12 years old. She started beating on that tambourine. Ding, ching, 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 in the name of Jesus. Ching, 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 come out of this child. Ding, ching, ching, in the name of Jesus. Ching, 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 ching. You don't have no business. Ching, 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 in this child. Ching, 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 ching. He can't give you, ching, 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 permission to be in him. Ching, 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 come out, come out. And I started crying. And I felt something hit me like a bolt of lightning in the top of my head. And she said, stand up. And I said, I can't, Mother Wilson. She said, stand up in the name of Jesus. And I stood up on the crutch and she snatched them from under my arms. And I started trying out my new legs. And I went home with the the crutches on my shoulder like a fishing pole. And I walked in the house and my mother started screaming, you walking, but how? And I was crying and she was crying and she came over to me. She grabbed me and I said, Mother Wilson, pray for me. And I'll never forget that. I walked out of a house, limped in and walked out. A lot of us have limped in relationships. Walked in marriages and limped out of in divorce. A lot of us have walked in relationships and limped out busted. A lot of us have walked in friends and limped out enemies. A lot of us have walked in rich and limped out poor. A lot of us have walked in happy and limped out sad. A lot of us, so I thank the Lord for saving me from myself. Yes. Silver and gold. The book of Acts, have I none, but such as I have, I give unto thee, co-worker. Arise and walk. We have to know when to leave. We have to know when to get away. I drowned at night, and the Lord saved me in that pond. Oh, yes, he did. I got hit by a car. I got stabbed at 17. Oh, help me, Lord. All I've been through, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Hold to God's unchanging hand. No matter which way the winds of life blow you, make sure you hold to God's unchanging hand. After all, it's a prerequisite that we possess this thing called faith, finding answers and trusting him as I leave this alone. I'm grateful unto the Most High God, my parents, Mother Wilson, all the deacons and preachers and elders and rabbinis and imams and pastors I've come in contact. God makes it hard for us to go to hell. In order to go to hell, you got to walk over every Sunday school lesson you've ever heard. In order to go to hell, you got to ignore every Baptist training unit, every Southern Baptist unit, every Islamic, every Jewish doctrine, every holy book, holy Bible, holy Quran. I mean, I got to say this. In order to go to hell, you're going to have to walk past and ignore every cathedral, every mass, every worship service, every salat, every prayer, every afternoon service, every Friday night prayer vigil, every midweek service. God makes it hard for us to go to hell. In order to go to hell, you got to ignore Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, David. You got to ignore Israel, Jacob, Moses, or Moshe. In order to go to hell, you got to ignore Paul and Silas and Timothy. God makes it hard for us to go to hell. Oh, yes, he does. He does. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Your current condition is not your final state. He's saved me time and time again, and he's never, ever failed me. Two things that our Father in heaven can't do, he cannot lie, and he changeth not. God bless you. God keep you is my ultimate prayer and uttermost prayer. The more you praise the Lord in your life, the more you raise the Lord in your life. Peace. One.